Holy shit. I can describe Godzilla Minus One in 3 words. Hollywood, take note.
Godzilla!
What is up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. This is OCD Mirror Reviews. My name is Ollen DeBrincat, and today I'm going to review the movie that everyone has been raving about, and that movie is
Godzilla Minus One.
This is the new Japanese Godzilla movie that is also celebrating the 70th anniversary of Godzilla himself, and this movie is directed by Takashi Yamazaki. Hopefully I said his name right. Post-World War II Japan is at its lowest point when a new crisis emerges in the form of a giant monster known as Godzilla, baptized in a horrific power of the atomic bomb. Now, this is coming from the guy that has not grown up with the Japanese Godzilla movies. Of course, the only one that I have seen is Godzilla vs. Kong from the 60s, because I remember seeing that movie once at my grandma's house. And yeah, it's very cheesy as hell, but of course, I grew up more with the American Godzilla movies than the Japanese Godzilla movies. Now, from Godzilla himself, the first time that I discovered Godzilla is actually not from the movies. It's actually from a video game. It's from a PS2 game called Godzilla Unleashed. Who remembers that game? Let me know in the comments below, where you get to play as Godzilla and you fight different titans and all that stuff.
Godzilla 2000. Dora. Monsters.
I just want that game to get remastered on PS5. Like, I don't think that's ever gonna happen. And by the way, like, off the subject, GTA 6, when it's coming out in 2025, come out right now so I can play you. But back to the subject, people have been raving about this new Godzilla movie. A lot of people said it's one of the best Godzilla films that came out in a long time, and also saying this movie is the best movie of this year. So of course, with all those reviews out, and I heard great things about, I had to go check out this movie, and the trailers actually do intrigue me. So I went to go see this movie on the biggest screen possible in IMAX. I gotta say, guys, for Godzilla Minus One, definitely see this film on the biggest screen possible in IMAX or any big screen that you find, because holy shit. I can describe Godzilla Minus One in 3 words. Hollywood, take notes, because this is how you do a movie right here. This is how you do a great Godzilla film, because no offense to the MonsterVerse movies, I enjoy them. They're just fun movies. They don't feel like movies. Godzilla Minus One felt like a great old school monster film. A monster film with a story that I completely care about throughout. And another thing that's the difference between the MonsterVerse Godzilla movies and this movie, there are characters in this movie that I do give a shit about in this film. Let's talk about the characters in this film, because every single one of the characters in Godzilla Minus One is fantastic. Now, I'm not going to explain the actor's name or the character's name because I'm really afraid to pronounce their names wrong, but the main guy in the film, the main soldier in this film, he plays a veteran soldier that has PTSD after the traumatic events from his past. I love this character because his character is definitely the most sympathetic throughout the entire film, because he's a completely broken character. He has a plot to do with taking care of this woman and this baby after this post-World War II event that he's gone through, and you really feel very bad for his character because he's one of those characters that you understand his motivation, you understand how broken he is, because the thing that happened in the past in the film is very unforgivable, and you really feel very bad for him in this entire freaking film. Obviously, I'm not going to spoil his past in the film. It does have to do with Godzilla in the film, but I want you guys to see it for yourself, because this character is definitely the most sympathetic character in the entire film, and he plays a really good main lead. Also, the woman with the baby that he has to take care of, she is also really good in this film. She presents a lot of great heart to this film. She has a great chemistry with the main guy in this film. Also, the three allies that the main character goes with, he works with them in a warboat. I really like those three characters in the film. They present some of the best humor of the year, but also they provide a lot of great heart to the film as well. Them four in this film provide a very good team in this film. That's what's so refreshing about this film. We have characters that we do care about, and also they have a lot to do with the story of this film. And the whole character study of this film, I thought it completely works for me. I think it really works in this movie. At times when I was watching the film, I'm like, this is a really good written drama film. And you forgot this is a Godzilla film in a good way. But of course, this is still a Godzilla film. Let's talk about Godzilla himself. Man, now I don't mind what they did with Godzilla in the American versions, in the MonsterVerse version, make him some hero and hope to the people. I don't mind that. But the way they did Godzilla in this movie is the way I want to see Godzilla, because Godzilla is a threat in this film. He's a villain. He's a monster in this film. And for the first time that I've seen Godzilla, they made him completely terrifying. The way Godzilla looks fantastic. He looks like a complete monster that you don't want to mess with. And just when you see him wrecking shit and stuff, it is fantastic to watch. Not for like popcorn entertainment and all that stuff, like guilty pleasure. It's actually presented very freaking well, because they make Godzilla so terrifying and so scary in this film, especially when it comes to his atomic breath in the film. Holy shit, I'm not gonna spoil what the atomic breath does, but my God, it creates one of the most terrifying atomic breaths that I've seen in Godzilla lore. But they made Godzilla a complete monster in this film. They made him a threat. And it has to do with the story, because after World War II, we think things gone done. Now Godzilla is wrecking shit, and it's ruining a lot of things from characters in this movie. And that's what I love about this movie. The story feels all connected. It doesn't feel like it's out of place. Every single moment of this film has its reasonings why it's there. The way Takashi Yamazaki directed this film is brilliant when it comes to the cinematography, the shots in this film. Even the score of this movie is fantastic. When the score comes in, it just felt so old school in the best way possible. But the story of the film is so well done. This movie has some funny moments, but of course, this is a very dark movie. This is a depressing movie, actually. There's a lot of emotional depth in this movie that I was literally feeling for. Like, seriously, I actually cried during this movie at a couple of moments, because when it comes to the emotional scenes, it is handled so well, especially with the acting in this film, with the main dude in the film. There's a bit where he explains his monologue, and honestly, it's one of the best acting performances of this entire year. From start to finish, this is the way to do a Godzilla film. I feel like Japan with this movie is telling Hollywood, this is how you do a movie right here. This is how you do a really good blockbuster with a great story and great heart. Because the way the film is directed as well, the screenplay is fantastic. Godzilla is freaking awesome to see. And this film has some memorable characters. It had some great characters that I have seen this year. I do have one little issue with this film, and to me, it is the ending of the film. Not the third act, because the third act is freaking awesome in this film, but the ending. There is a subplot of the film that happens, and I thought the film was just going to continue that throughout the end of the movie. And then somehow, there's a convenience that happened in this film where I'm just like, okay, that came out of nowhere. Even though it's a very good ending, it's a very emotional ending, it does feel very rushed, and it does feel like it is a little out of place and coming out of nowhere. When you watch this film, you know what I'm talking about. But honestly, throughout the ending of the film, I hear a lot of people crying throughout the end of this movie. It is an emotional ending, but at the same time, I have to get a little nitpicky. It did came out of nowhere, that subplot that randomly comes. And also, the ending definitely sets up for something. And honestly, I do want to see a sequel to Godzilla Minus One, because seriously, this is the way to do a Godzilla movie, and also this is the way to do a monster movie in general. Overall, Godzilla Minus One. what a big surprise this year. This definitely is the best Godzilla film that I have ever seen. The story of this film is fantastic. The characters I definitely root for throughout. Godzilla, this is one of the best adaptations of Godzilla that I've ever seen. They made him a complete monster in this film, complete threat, and they made him completely horrifying in this film. The action scenes are great, the emotional standpoints are great, the characters are very fantastic. And Takashi Yamazaki, he directed this movie extremely well. So overall, guys, go see Godzilla Minus One as soon as you can. Even though if you haven't seen a Japanese Godzilla movie, this movie definitely stands out on its own. And I am going to give Godzilla Minus One an A.
Run! It's Godzilla!
So guys, that is my review for Godzilla Minus One. Let me know what you think of this film in the comments below. And what is your favorite Godzilla film of all time? Let me know that also in the comments below. Make sure you guys follow me on social media links down below. Keep contact with me and make sure you guys subscribe to my channel for my latest movie reviews and other movie related content. Thank you guys so much for watching and have a nice day.